What's up? Welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be doing our first ever TED Talk. You get what I'm saying? You know what a TED Talk is. Basically, someone sits down and talks about a situation or talk about anything. So today, we're going to be talking about my upcoming clothing line, The Courageous Collection. I know a lot of you all have asked if I still want to do the clothing line or any updates on the clothing line, so this video, I'm going to give you all some updates about the clothing line. Also, give you some tips on how to start your own clothing line. So while you're here, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead and follow my first business page, ChristineCrazy22 on Instagram. Follow my personal page, The Real Queen Tracy. And follow The Curvaceous Collection on Instagram. So let's go ahead and get into this video. Get you some lemonade and some popcorn. Girl, we about to chat.
Used to talk about me, but now my name all in they search now. Pretty in the face, little in the waist. I talk my shit, I get cocky. These bitches won't be me, these bitches can't see me. Got CC all over my body. Killing bitches is a hot.
So welcome back, you guys. So today, like I said earlier, we're going to be talking about my new upcoming clothing line, The Curvaceous Collection. We specialize in plus-size clothing, sizes 1X to 3X. More on-trend, casual, and dressy clothes is what we're looking and targeting right now. Our launch got pushed back to the fall because of the coronavirus situation and pandemic in the world. And the China vendors were closed for months, and then the United States turned around and closed for a month and a half. So that's why it got delayed. It was originally supposed to launch last week in April. April 25th to be exact was our first original launch date, but that was changed, you know, with everything that was going on. So I just want to give you guys an update. I'm still working on it. I'm still looking for vendors. I'm still testing out clothes. I'm still trying to get the good quality for you all. And I know it's very hard to find good plus size clothes because I am a plus size woman, and I know that difficulty and what goes along with it. I want my clothes to be affordable and fashionable and trendy. So that's the goal right now, and I'm still working on it. So all my plus size ladies, don't give up on me, okay? I'm working diligently to do it. So again, another thing we're going to talk about in this video is ways to start your own clothing line. I haven't officially launched, but I have been doing my own research, finding my own vendors, going through doing things the correct and right way. So I wanted to show and give you guys these tips that I'm using currently to start my brand, start my clothing line, and expand my business. So I have my notes, handy dandy notebook right here. So the first tip I have for you all is to plan everything. So when I mean plan everything, it's like I wrote out the clothes that I wanted, the goals that I wanted for my business. How much I wanted to price, how much is my price bracket, what sizes I wanted to wear. Also, I not wanted to wear, but wanted to sell, also played a role in it. Because at first, I was saying, oh, I could do all sizes of the plus size. And I was like, you know what? No. Because there's not a lot of plus size brands that cater to real plus size women, if that makes sense. So I was like, maybe that's something that I should do. So planning is everything, and that's what any business, not just a clothing line. Planning is everything. Number two, know your competition. So your competition may not always be those big industries. It can be other small businesses. Like, for instance, you have like a Swank Posh. She sells plus size clothes as well. You have a couple other plus size brands out here that are so big in corporate, but they are big small businesses. So you look at your competition, you study your competition, you see their price ranges, their price points. You try to compare the quality of your clothes to their clothes. But sometimes you end up supporting the competition to get more information for your brand. A lot of people don't believe that, but it really works. Because if you know that person's brand and how the quality of their clothes, you know how you can really compare your clothes to other businesses, you know? So you have to support other businesses to do your research as well. Set a budget. So the thing with me, I set out to order samples. I think so far I probably spent like $150 in samples, which is not bad. I really didn't find the one item out of those samples that I tried out that I actually liked and would bring to my line so far. So yeah, make a budget. Set a budget for your samples. Don't go all willy-nilly crazy. and buy every sample because it's cheap. It doesn't work like that. Ladies, I have went to wholesale places in Atlanta to go look at their clothes and didn't like none of them. And y'all looked on the websites and they were nice too. So, you don't always have to buy for someone from China. My goal is to have US vendors so I can get stuff in quick, or if I can be able to go pick it up. So in Atlanta, we have Atlanta Merchant Mark. I'm patiently waiting for that to reopen. Due to the pandemic, it has been closed for a whole month. So our little wholesale district has been closed here. So I'm just waiting for it to reopen for me to go down and visit things myself and try out these clothes. So number four, create products that people actually buy. Don't go out there and go buy those tacky old jeans and random clothes that you won't even buy, but you trying to sell to somebody else. I wouldn't sell nobody something that I wouldn't wear. And that's something that I stand by. If I'm not going to wear it, if I don't rip my own brand, why would I buy it? Why would I sell it to other people? And that's a thing that a lot of businesses go wrong at. That you just start trying to sell any and everything to get a dollar. It's not always about the money. It's about the quality, about your passion, about your consistency. All that good stuff plays a role in your business. And creating products that people actually buy. With plus size women, it's hard for us to find good clothes. So my goal is always to have good quality. That is the main highest goal for my clothing line, is to have great quality clothes that don't stray, that run true to size. So if you know all the things that I needed for your clothing line, that makes it so much easier at the end of the day. Know your target market. So knowing your target market is another reason why I said my focus is plus size. So my target market is plus size women of all ages, honestly. Plus size women don't get enough love in the fashion industry. So that's where I come in. I want to make sure that we have trendy. I feel like I'm putting myself with trendy, fashionable, and affordable clothes that actually fit your curves. So that is the goal. That's my target market. You need to know your target market. If you are a smaller woman and you want to sell clothes, okay, your target market should be sizes small, XL up to extra large. Everyone has a different target market, so keep that in mind as well. Follow trends. So everyone know in fashion that they have so many trends that's going on. Right now, I would say like lizard print is in. Not lizard print, like reptile looking prints are in. Everyone loves dark clothes. And it's the springtime, so pastel colors are slowly coming back in. The summertime, you all know people want some shades, some anklets, all that good stuff. So always follow trends. See what the other big businesses are doing, what fabrics they're dropping, what patterns they're dropping. Always keep researching. That is the main important thing with having any business, to continue to research. And watch your competitors, because they will teach you something. Research vendors. Read reviews, do quality checks. That's why samples are important. Don't go and buy a boatload of clothes or jewelry or whatever you sell from a vendor because it's cheap. Everything is, what is it saying? Everything that glitter ain't gold. That's the truth when it comes to owning a business or ordering samples for clothes. I've seen so many cheap samples on these websites and I'm like, oh, okay. It raises flags because everything that's cheap, the quality is going to meet that price. So if you pay a nice little buck for that, it may have better quality. Some cheap stuff does have good quality. I'm not going to lie about that. But you have to think because it can be sketchy at times, especially order from China, because you cannot send that stuff back, y'all. You cannot send it back. So keep that in mind as well. So the last thing I'm going to talk about is promotion and marketing. Promotion and marketing for any brand, any business, any clothing line, whatever you do, marketing and promotion and branding all are under the same umbrella, and they're very important. You have to promote your business. You have to brand your business. You have to, if nobody else gonna push your business, you push your business. You post every day about your YouTube. You post every day about your upcoming clothing line. You post every day about whatever jewelry is about to drop or whatever you sell. So you have to constantly promote. People gonna get tired of seeing your posts, but I promise you, after a couple more times, they might come visit your page, they might go look at your channel, they might even shop your website. You never know. But if you don't push it, no one will know about it. Social media plays a huge role in business. Facebook and Instagram have platforms where you can pay to get your posts advertised. I quite often use Instagram promotions for my Christine Creations business. Maybe once a week I'll run an ad on Instagram about our current sales or new added items or whatnot. The cheapest promotion is about $5, and that's for a whole day. And you may target, and it may be visible to up to 1,000 people. You can go all the way up to $100. You can go up to 30 days for a promotion. Whatever your budget is, you can do it. Instagram and Facebook have very affordable paid ads for your businesses. Lowest $5, sometimes lower than that, but that's, you know, kind of wasting your time because if it's only up for a couple hours and you only reaching like 200-300 people, then that's really not worth it. So I would say the lowest you should go is $5 for a Facebook or Instagram promotion. It goes a long way. It brings people to your page that never would have found your page. It also shows different, it opens up your target market, opens up your business to other people that may not even know that you even exist. I have gotten plenty of followers off of just doing Instagram and Facebook ads. I'm really not, Christine Creations really isn't heavy on Facebook. We're more an Instagram-based business, but for the sake of my clothing line, I do want to post on Facebook and push Facebook a little bit more because Facebook gives you a different target market. You know, Facebook has not older people, but they have like people over the age of 35 more on Facebook than on Instagram. So those are people who have the extra money or does not mind spending a pretty penny on clothes or whatever you sell. So keep that in mind when it comes to your advertisement as well. What is your target market? Is Instagram better to promote or is Facebook better to promote for your business? Use both, but sometimes I use Instagram more for Christine Creations because my target market is people my age and most of us are on Instagram. Not most, but all on Instagram. But for my clothing line, I have an open target market as long as you're plus size. So Facebook is going to be a good tool for me to use for that as well. So, and the last two things I want to say is networking. Networking is very important. You have to communicate with other entrepreneurs. Everyone is not your competition. Some people can help you. I've learned that with Christine Creations, I have a faithful group of customers that we also help each other. We talk and communicate. We share ideas. We give ideas. It's not always about keeping all the knowledge to yourself. You have to share knowledge. That's like sharing wealth. You have knowledge is wealth, so you need to share it with other people. So if you can help someone, do that. Network with other people because you never know when you're going to need that person for your business or when you have a brain fart or can't think about something and you need someone to help you generate ideas. That is the importance of networking. So last but not least, know your worth. Don't let anyone talk down about your business. Don't let anyone discourage you from doing your business and being the best that you can be. Know your worth. You're going to have those haters. You're going to have those trolls. No matter what business you have. Clothing line, jewelry. You can be cutting grass. And somebody can be hating on you. Know your worth. So I hope these tips are very helpful for you all. I want to keep this video short and sweet. So if you guys have any questions, comment below. Let me know what you all want to see on my channel. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow Christine Creations 22 on Instagram. Follow The Real Queen Tracy on Instagram. And follow The Curvaceous Collection on Instagram as well. I will do more videos targeted just towards my clothing line as well as videos targeted just towards Christine Creations. So thank you guys for subscribing. We're almost at 1K. Hopefully by the time this video uploads, we already meet 1K and beat 1K. Then we're going to be on the way to getting monetized. So make sure y'all watch all my videos all the way through. Help me become monetized. Help me get this quaint. Okay? But anyway, y'all have a great day. Today's Thursday, and this video is going to go up today, Thursday. Not too much editing is going to go into this because I really feel like I was to the point. So make sure you, again, like, comment, and subscribe. I will see y'all on Friday. I'm still going to post tomorrow. So I want to give you guys an extra video this week because I didn't post any last week. So I want to do one extra video this week to see if you guys like that. If you guys want me to start posting 3 times a week, comment below. Let me know what you want to see. Also, I'm thinking about starting up doing hauls and things of that nature. Blue. And things of that nature as well. Y'all look at me. Boo-boo. You want to get a camera. But y'all have a great day. I'm babbling at this point. But comment below what you guys want to see on the channel. What y'all expect. If you want the deets on this wig, this is a West Kiss 20-inch curly wig from Amazon. I'll put the link below for you all to purchase it. You all have a great day. See y'all on Friday, and I'm out.